For now, let's continue our discussion on operations research, and we have game theory. Okay, so let me start. Ito yung coverage natin. We will have game theory, the introduction, what is the saddle point method. This is just one of the many methodologies in game theory. No, marami kasing iba't-ibang paraan, no, under yung cluster ng game theory. And one example, and then we will have our assignment. Okay? So first, let's try to define what game theory is all about. No? So game theory was developed by John von Neumann and Oscar Morgenstern in 1928. This is the study of mathematical models of strategic interactions among rational agents. And it has applications in all fields of social science as well as in logic systems, science, and computer science. So, malawak yung coverage niya, no? Originally, it addressed two persons zero-sum games in which each participant gains or losses are acted exactly balanced by those of other participants. Now, in the 21st century, game theory applies to a wide range of behavioral relations, and it is now an umbrella term for the science of logical decision making in humans, animals, as well as computers. So, from the term itself, ano, game theory, it is as if you are playing a game, ano, but there is a mathematical application to it. Para kang naglalaro ng chess, ano, and you have your resources as pieces in your game. Now, whether it is humans, animals, computers, so on and so forth. So, mathematical models lang siya na nag-a-advance, ano. And what we will be doing today is just a basic, okay? Basic example lang siya. Pero if you will delve on deeper applications of it, mas malawak na yung examples at saka yung numbers na ginagamit, ano? So ayun, game and types of games, ito yung ilan sa mga examples natin. We have cooperative and non-cooperative games, normal form and extensive form games, simultaneous moves, sequential moves, no? O kumbaga, there is a sequence, kailangan mo munang ma-finish yung isang step before you proceed with the other. Zero-sum and non-zero-sum games, symmetric and asymmetric games. So I know these terms are alien to you. Pagka narinig mo siya, parang I don't know what's the meaning of all of this. But what I'm just trying to show you is that marami again ang mga methodologies under game theory. Okay? And yung pag-aaralan natin today is just one of the many, no? Which is the saddle point. Okay? So ayan, again, just to give definitions to those, no? Two person, two players, of course, from the term itself. Zero sum, a game in which sums of amounts won by all winners is equal to the sum of amounts lost by the loser. So, pareho, no? There is an equal amount of wins and losses. Non-zero sum game, a game in which the sum of gains and losses are not equal. If it's not equal, non-zero sum game. So, a pure strategy game in which the best strategy for each player is to play one strategy throughout the game, and mixed strategy is a game in which each player employs different strategies at different times in the game. So, again, ano, as we cover or hopefully finish yung game theory na before your finals, malalaman ninyo yung applications ng bawat isa dito sa mga game na ito. Okay? So, yung una natin pag-aaralan is yung saddle point, no? Ano ba yung saddle point method na tinatawag? So, at the right of each row, no, so there is a given, and then there are rows and columns, which I will show you later. And then yung method is this, okay? At the right of each row, you write the row minimum and underline the largest, no? At the bottom of each column, write the column maximum and underline the smallest. And then if these two elements are equal, kapag equal daw, zero sum, ano? Pag equal siya, the corresponding cell is the saddle point and the value is the true value of the game. Okay? if equal siya, no? Pag hindi naman equal, then wala kang true value at hindi mo makukuha yung saddle point. Okay? So, I hope clear tayo dyan. At para mas maintindihan natin, let's look at an example, ano? So, ito yung example ng saddle point. Okay? So, I want you to visualize this na meron kang, in an operations perspective, may dalawa kang tao, no? Or let's say, ito yung mga resources mo. At gusto mong ma-maximize yung bawat move na gagawin nila or bawat, let's say, task na gagawin nila. And these numbers could represent anything. It could be sales, it could be transportation, it could be anything, ano? Pinapakita lang natin siya in a form of mathematical equation para alam mo yung pag triangulate at pag check no kung ano yung best option for your players. Okay? So saddle point method. No? You have player A and then player B. Yung player A can make three moves represented by the call the rows, no? So meron siyang one row, second row, at third row. Ito yung mga move na pwedeng gawin ng player A. While player B is limited to two moves, no? Which is represented by the columns. So, column 1 and then column 2. Okay? So, pag na-plot mo na siya, it looks like this, and then you have here minimum of rows and then maximum of columns. So minimum number of rows and then maximum number in the columns. Okay? So anyways, yung mga given naman na ibibigay sa inyo, nakaganyan na siya. So wala naman na kayong dapat i-worry. Okay? So sabi kanina, no, kukunin natin yung least sa rows. Okay? Ayan, balikan ko lang saglit. At the right of each row, write the minimum. No? Isulat mo daw yung minimum or kukunin natin yung minimum. So on this row, the first move ni player A, kunin mo yung minimum which is negative 3. Okay, ito yung kinuha natin, no? Based dun sa rule natin. Nilagay natin siya dito. Move number 2 for player A. So, pinakamababa sa dalawa would be negative 2, no? And paalala ko lang sa inyo, no, ang 'di ba sa numerical system, ang positive numbers goes to the right and negative goes to the left, ano? So, sa negative concept, no, the lower the number, the higher its value is, right? Kasi mas malapit ka sa 0 eh. So the farther you are in zero, mas bumababa yung amount. Kaya hindi kagaya nung sa positive na mas malayo ka sa zero, mas mataas. I hope we are all in the same page. Para hindi kayo malito, kunwari dalawang negative yung nakuha mo, kukunin mo yung minimum doon. Minimum in terms of the amount. So kung kunwari ito ay negative 3 at saka negative 2, ang kukunin mo yung negative 3, yun yung mas mababa, hindi yung negative 2. Okay? So tatandaan ninyo yan, class, ha? Again, minimum in terms of the amount, no? For the third move, okay, third move natin, minimum is 2. If we would compare the 2, no? 2 and 3, of course, mas mababa yung 2. So ngayon, nakuha mo na yung tatlo, no? Negative 3, negative 2, at 2. Ito yung mga lowest amounts in the rows. Okay, so na-satisfy na natin yung isang rule doon sa definition ng saddle point earlier. So ano naman ang gagawin natin? Next na gagawin natin would be to check on the moves of player B, which is represented by the columns. Okay, so dito, ang kukunin mo naman daw based sa instruction ay yung maximum amount on the columns. Ano yung pinakamalaking value? Okay? So, ang pinakamalaking value natin ay 2. Okay? So, dahil 2, you put it down, Tapos ganun din ang gagawin mo dito kung ano yung pinakamalaking value. So naturally, 6 ang pinakamalaki, no? 6, 4, 3. Okay, so 6. So ayan. Na-plot mo na ngayon yung mga kailangan mo. So you have the minimum of rows at saka maximum of columns. So nakuha na natin siya. So ano naman ang next na gagawin natin, ano? Medyo malayo na kasi yung slide na yun, ano, pag binalikan ko, marami yung iba back. So, proceed na ako dito and I'll just explain it to you na lang. Ano. So, ang next na gagawin mo, no, kung mababalikan natin yung slide na yun, is that you would get the maximum out of the minimum, no, dun sa area mo of the minimum, which is represented by the rows, kunin mo daw yung maximum number. At ang tawag doon, no, in operations research, game theory, ay maximin. Maximin refers to the maximum number out of the minimum values. Okay? So parang pinag-join for siya, no, max at minimum naging maximin. Yan yung mga minsan nakakalito na, no, kaya kailangan susundan mo siya step by step. So maximin is 2. Kasi siya yung pinakamataas out of the 3. Negative 3, negative 2, 2. So yan, this is maximum. Next naman, no, maximum of column. So medyo may idea na kayo kung anong gagawin natin dito. No? Ang gagawin mo naman dito is this. Kukunin mo yung minimum number out of the maximum values. Kasi ito naman dito sa row natin, sa columns rather, may dalawa kang results, kukunin mo yung pinakamababa, minimum number out of the maximum values. Okay? Ang tawag naman doon ay minimax. So, ang kulit ng mga terms, no? Minimax is the minimum number out of the maximum value. So, you have 2 and 6, you get 2. Okay? Kasi siya yung pinakamababa out of the maximum columns. So, nalaman mo na, kanina dito you have 2, tapos dito you have 2. So, ano siya? Equal siya, no? Pareho siyang 2. Okay? So, kung pareho daw, kung equal, ang sabi, pwede mong makuha yung saddle point. Kasi kung dito, hindi mag-equal yung numbers na nakuha mo for rows and columns, hindi mo makukuha ang saddle point. But rather, ibang game theory methodology ang gagamitin mo. Hindi saddle point. But since equal to, pwede natin kunin yung saddle point. Okay? I hope that is clear with everyone. So, if maximin and is equal to minimax, yan yung sinasabi ko, then the cell where the corresponding row and column meet is called the saddle point. And the value in the cell is called the game value. Okay? So, dahil nga equal siya, pwede mong kunin yung saddle point at alam mo yung game value. So ano ba yon? Ayan siya oh. Ito ngayon yung saddle point, this one. Kasi dito nag-meet yung dalawa eh. Nag-meet yung column mo at saka row mo. Okay? And the value in the cell is called the game value. So ito yung point ha. Saddle point lang yan. No? Huwag niyong pagkamalian. Saddle point is not 2. No? Mamaya makikita nyo what is the saddle point. Pero in terms of visual, makikita mo, ito yung saddle point. Pero merong coordinates yan, ano, may number yan na nire-represent niya. And yung game value is the value inside the cell. So ang laman daw ng cell ay 2, therefore that is the game value. Okay? So ano naman kung nalaman na natin siya? Okay? Saddle point becomes 3 and 1. Okay? So, bakit 3 and 1? Kasi it means third row, column 1. Yun yung coordinate niya, no? Location niya. Row 3, column 1. Kaya yan na nakalagay. Saddle point is 3, 1. And then the game value is the value inside the cell. So, it is 2. Okay? So, tingnan natin. No? So, again, sabi natin kanina, ang game theory, it's as if you are using your resources in a game and then making sure that you maximize each move and then maximize yung mga steps nila, no? Your resources. So what's the optimal strategy for player A? So again, no, sabi natin kanina, player A has three moves. Pwede siya mag-move dito sa first row, second row, or third row. And through the determination of saddle point, nakita natin na andito siya sa third row. So what you will do is, i-X out mo na itong dalawa, no? Kaya 0, 0. Kasi yung first row, 0, hindi yan ang kukunin mo. Second row, hindi rin yun ang kukunin mo, kaya 0. And then 1, itong third row. No, bakit 1? Kasi ibig sabihin optimum, no, 100%. So ilalaan mo diyan. Kaya 1 ang nakalagay. So it therefore is 001. Yun yung optimal strategy mo for player A. Okay? Next, player B naman. Your optimal strategy for player B, sorry, napalaki lang yung X, ano? Na covera no tuloy na sa gitna. Player B, kasi column naman ng kanyang moves, player B, dito ka lang mag-move kasi nga, nandito yung saddle point mo eh. So kung pipili ka sa dalawa, ito ang pipiliin ko na move kasi ito, hindi ko makukuha yung optimal strategy dyan. Kaya zero yung second column. And yung first column, one. One means 100% probability, no? Ilalaan mo doon sa first column mo yung move mo. So therefore, player A, optimal strategy is 001, and player B's strategy is 10. Okay? So yan, ano, very simple lang naman itong topic natin ngayon, ano. So ngayon, ganito, this is supposed to be an activity, no? Pero para ma-save na rin yung time natin, ibibigay ko siya sa inyo as an assignment which you can do on your own, ano? So, solve and determine whether there is a saddle point. So, alamin nyo muna, meron bang saddle point at game value from the given scenario? If yes, then alamin mo yung saddle point, game value, and optimal strategies for player A and player B. Okay? So, yun po. Any questions before we wrap up our meeting today? So, I think there's none. Wala naman nag-raise ng question. If there are, just send me a message. Ano po.